YouTube, welcome to CAFE ENOMA and welcome to our reaction to RITA, COOLIDGE. And the song that we are going to react to is We Are All Alone.
Probably RITA, COOLIDGE.
COOLIDGE.
Okay. We Are All Alone, okay.
Listening to it for the first time, as usual on this channel. Let's see.
Outside the rain begins, and it may never end. So cry no more on the shore, a dream will take us out to sea.
Voices like these would sing.
Yeah, you do have few of them though.
Current? I'm not sure. I don't hear one from the current time.
She has one of the best voices we've heard, doesn't she?
Yeah.
So earthy, you know, it's so pure, it's so raw, it's so innocent. Like, you know, the beauty of voices like hers, and I don't say this often, in fact, I've never said it before, I think. The beauty of a voice like hers is it's like it's the first time she's ever singing.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. That's how you feel. She's got a beautiful voice, yes, like thousands of others have beautiful voices. But you know, you don't have that quality, that sterling quality that she has, which makes you feel like it's the first time, you know. It's like a virgin voice. She first time she's ever taken to the mic and recording a song like this. Absolutely breathtaking, absolutely beautiful. Wow, this is a name I'll remember. Rita Coolidge. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful song. You know what I thought of? Unique, which most people who come to this reaction may not have a clue what I'm saying.
Okay.
But I thought of this song immediately, you know, from... what was that movie? Dimple Kapadia and Rishi Kapoor. You know, Hum tum ek kamre mein band ho aur chavi ko jaye. Haan, Bobby. It was a very big movie, even though very well
even
in
today,
East European countries, Russia, Ukraine and all that.
Yeah.
Bobby. So it reminded me of that song instantly. You know, when I heard this song, the lyrics, the way it went after the first verse. And the chorus.
Actually, it says we are all alone.
Yeah, you know, hum to mein kamre mein band ho, which means you and me, let's get locked together in a room.
And
single
the key
room,
is lost.
And the key is lost. Aur chavi kho jaye, aur chavi kho jaye. Instantly reminded me of that wonderful song from this very romantic Bollywood movie. So nice. Beautiful, beautiful voice. The singer has. What did you think of the music, her voice, the song, the lyrics?
I truly liked her voice. I just can't get over her voice, the way she sang this one. Wow. I don't think anybody could have thought of the term that he gave it, the virgin voice. Even though the person who's singing, the singer, is quite mature and, you know, knows what she's singing, but the way that voice comes, they hardly knew how to manipulate them. You know, they hardly knew how to manipulate to maybe make it sound better, make it sound this way or that way. They knew one mantra and that was their originality. They knew that what I have, what is my capacity, what is my talent, if I do it the honest way, that's the best thing that I can do. That's the best justice that I can do to my music. And that's exactly what I got to hear over here. I liked the song, what it was. It felt genuine. It felt nice. It felt home-like. You know, and not too many. I mean, I kept thinking, these kind of musicians, these kind of singers, this kind of originality you don't really get to hear these days. Everything is just made to be liked. It's not... you, but it's you're trying to make something to be liked by someone or some people.
You know,
it's not you.
The thing is, it's not that these singers aren't there. It's just that they aren't given an opportunity
they
were back then.
Yeah.
Back then, you sung at someone's birthday party like Mariah Carey. Or you sang at someone's wedding
and
like
someone
some
spotted
other
you.
Singer rose to fame. Or you sang at someone's office function. Somewhere or the other you sang at someone's home maybe, or in your own home, you know, people would listen to you and say, wow, I want this guy, I want to back this guy, this girl, I want to get behind her, I want to put money behind her, I want to invest in her future. Today, that doesn't happen. People want that instant fame, and because there are so many examples of it, people don't really want to wait. You know, wait and watch or wait it out. They don't want to stick with someone, even though they do have that same reaction initially. Even today, you have those birthday party singers and those wedding singers and those people who, you know, they just post a video on their Facebook or, and you'll say, wow, what a voice she's got. But no one is willing to wait it out. They may support her then, they may give her likes. No one is willing to wait it out. No one is willing to stick their neck out for that person. Like they did back then. And that is why you don't have those singers making it big. At that time, people were willing to do that. They were managers.
Yeah.
They were scouts. Literally, scouts.
Yeah.
They were like eagle scouts. They were looking out for people with talent.
Hunters.
And they were willing to wait. They had budgets. They had the time. They were willing to wait 10 years, 12 years for that person to actually flourish and make it really, really big. The same goes with writing. You know, earlier with writers, if you look at the state of the book industry today, it's not just that people don't like reading books. This lockdown has showed that people do like reading books. You know, people have gone back to books and they love it, even youngsters. The e-books, audiobooks, everything has done well. Podcasts. Suddenly, there's been
all kinds of
resurgence of all these formats, which people thought
literature may
not do well. In these times. But the fact is, why did the books and the writers go down? Why don't you have great writers anymore? like whether it's in the horror category like Stephen King, you still have those same people writing, or you still remember those same people. You know, you don't have Mills and Boone anymore. You don't have the greats in different categories anymore, because the same thing. People are not willing to wait it out. Agents, literary agents, book agents, call it what you will, they're not willing to wait it out with someone.
Because there are too many.
But this is a pure voice. Moving back to that song and the topic, this was wow.
There are so many Weinsteins in every single industry that they want some benefit before they cast you, instead of really letting you have an original talent and flourish.
Yeah, the Cosbys, the Weinsteins.
Yeah. They are looking for their own benefit. They are not looking for talent.
Thousands of others are
they
there.
They have ruined the art.
Who, instead of being good mentors, being good role models.
Looking for real talent.
I mean,
they want
so
something
many,
from
so
you.
So many. It's not just the men. It's even the women.
Yeah. I'm saying that's a name given. There are so many faces and, you know, forms of them. Thank you for watching this one. That's all.